Lagan joins us now, co-founder of Home Depot, and he's got a new book out called I Love Capitalism, American Story. Ken, thank you very much for joining us, and I'm pleased to say I have spent over the years a lot of money at Home Depot, so I hope
we appreciate that very much, Doug, and I'm honored to be on your show.
I hope it helped you out in the long run. Give us the premise of I Love Capitalism, an American Story.
It's very simple. Capitalism is the engine that's driven the genius of America. No doubt about it. We have developed an economic system that's the envy of the world, the entire world. And it all comes about through human initiative and human imagination and creativity. And frankly, I was rather benign about wanting to write a book until I saw all these kids following Bernie Sanders in 2016, and it frightened me. Because if kids haven't even begun the race, give up, nothing's left. Capitalism works, and it works for everybody. Yeah, you got to have certain traits and maybe be a little wacky like I am, but you got to have energy, and you've got to have a will and a desire to win. You've got to have the ability to snap back from setbacks or defeat and pick yourself up and move on. But we live in a society where if you can determine a human want or a human need, and you can figure a way out to fulfill that human want or human need, you can have a business and you can succeed. Whether it's a little dry cleaning establishment on the street corner, or one guy with a pickup truck with one lawnmower out cutting people's lawns. And because he does such a good job, he gets referrals, and all of a sudden he needs another guy, and he needs another lawnmower, and then he needs 10 more. I mean, capitalism should not just be defined by behemoth corporations. It should be defined by people who are engaged in commerce in a way that it enhances the society it's in. And that's, to me, the genius of capitalism.
I also think that it requires something that many of us do not have, and that's the willingness to accept failure and then get back up again and go again and try again.
Absolutely. If you haven't got the resolve to snap back, I mean, to me, a good example was Ray Kroc, McDonald's Corporation. Look at how old he was, and look at the number of things he tried that didn't work. You know, you don't always go to the plate and hit a home run. You strike out every once in a while. And I'll be very forthright. If you gave me 6 months, I wouldn't have enough time to tell you about all my failures. But failures does not give you any kind of right to give up. And in fact, there's no defeat except in giving up. When you give up, it's gone. It's all over.
I think of Colonel Sanders, Colonel Harlan Sanders, who
exactly.
He made and lost millions.
I was fortunate to be on the board of the company that owned the KFC brand, Yum Brands. And David Novak is a good example of an entrepreneur. He takes over this company that was buried inside of a major corporation. He takes it out, and he turns it into a thriving, growing, dramatic business. As I said, these opportunities are out there. If you haven't got the will, and you haven't got the determination, and you haven't got the resolve that, okay, this didn't work, but I'm not giving up.
So you say you're not self-made.
I am not self-made. I'm hardly self-made. I can think through my entire life of the number of people that gave me a lift along the way or helped me. My parents, my brother, my relatives. When I was a kid working, the fellow that ran the liquor store that I used to collect the cardboard from, Lenny Altman, professors in college, my wife, my kids. Every place I look, I see somebody that's helped me. So how can I say I'm self-made? I'm not.
I love the book title. I Love Capitalism, an American Story. Ken, thank you so much for your time today. We greatly appreciate it. And keep on going.
Well, thank you for having me. I appreciate your thoughtfulness.
Thank you.
Ken Lagan, he's also the co-founder of Home Depot. Yeah. Like I said, I spent a fortune in that place over there.